welcome, 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 welcome to The Tonight Show, everyone. You're here. Thank you for watching. President Biden spent the past 2 days in Scotland addressing world leaders at the UN Climate Change Summit. Yep, Biden reiterated his commitment to cut carbon emissions in half by 2030, and he can do it. I mean, he cut his approval rating in half in 3 months. Biden ended his big speech by saying, God bless you all, and may God save the planet. And God was like, this is definitely a you broke it, you bought it situation. Well, good news, over 100 countries have agreed to stop deforestation by 2030. Yeah. In other words, they agreed to stop giving a Brazilian rainforest a Brazilian. But it wasn't just world leaders at the summit. Leonardo DiCaprio was also there. Oh. Apparently, he heard Earth was getting hotter and needed to meet her. Actually, DiCaprio does a lot to fight global warming. It all started with that iceberg. Some more news from overseas at Shanghai Disneyland. Do you hear about this? After one person tested positive for COVID, more than 30,000 visitors weren't allowed to leave the park until they tested negative. 30,000. Parents were like, this is awful. Well, every kid was like, best day ever. Oh my. Trapped in Disneyland? At first, everyone at Disneyland were mad. They had to spend hours sitting around and waiting. Then they remembered that's what they paid for in the first place. That's right, Mickey gives you a COVID test and then they charge you $40 for a photo. It's unbelievable. You guys hear about this? Apparently there are issues with the toilet on the SpaceX capsule. So 4 astronauts are gonna have to use backup undergarments during their trip home. Astronauts were like, you know, not sure we needed to make that public. We're doing tons of other stuff up here. Meanwhile, I saw that NASA astronauts used the first peppers grown in space to make tacos on the International Space Station. I guess they figured, well, the toilet's broken. Taco Tuesday, anyone? What? Is anyone thinking here? Next, we're gonna have a prune-eating contest. And some business news. Peloton has partnered with Delta Airlines to offer stretching and meditation classes on their flights. I don't know about this. I mean, after being delayed for 3 hours, even the Dalai Lama would be like, come on, let's go. That's my Dalai Lama impression.
It's uncanny.
That's the only
it's
impression.
It's uncanny how
thank
accurate.
Thank you, yeah. No one else does the Dalai Lama.
No.
Come on. I don't even care if I beat the luggage there. I don't care. Speaking of travel, American Airlines is having a rough time in the past few days. They had to cancel over 2,000 flights. Due to staffing and weather problems, yeah. At this point, flying to Charlotte is like crossing the Atlantic in 1750. My beloved Isabel, our journey has been long and hard. Well, get this, I heard that Zoom, you guys know Zoom, obviously, yeah? Zoom's gonna start showing ads. Oh. Yeah, the only thing missing from your 4-hour work-long meetings were commercials. Yes. Well, this is actually fun. Heinz just launched a Christmas dinner in a can. Look at this. There you go. Just like Mom used to make when she was in prison. Hey, I read that here in New York City, the Met is putting on an opera that's 6 hours long. Yeah, it's a famous opera called A Terrible Idea During a Pandemic. 6 hours, yeah. Each guest is handed a playbill and a pair of astronaut undergarments.
Oh!
Taco Tuesday! And finally, a man in California returned home to find a pretty interesting scene. Look at this.
John Holden says when he returned home, he was surprised to find his front door wide open and quickly noticed that bear on the counter scarfing down a bucket of KFC. Unfortunately, one of his pet parakeets is still missing.
Colonel Sanders was like, oh no, they finally found out our secret recipe. Let's get to some news. Guys, earlier today, President Biden returned to Washington, D.C. after a 6-day trip to Europe. And he saw last night's election results and went right back to Europe. Yep, Biden's back home, but last night in the UK, his motorcade actually missed the exit for the airport and had to make a U-turn. Yep, Biden's motorcade didn't know where it was going. I'll take on-the-nose metaphors for 200, please, Mike. Officials knew that they were gonna get lost when Biden handed the driver 14 pages of printed directions from MapQuest.
I think this is the best way to get to the...
Yeah, well, as I mentioned, there were a bunch of state and local elections yesterday, and it was a tough night for Democrats, starting with their loss in the Virginia governor's race. And now Republicans are out celebrating. Today, Mitch McConnell and Ted Cruz were spotted holding hands on a roller coaster. Let the rumors begin, yeah. Yet Republicans haven't been this excited since they realized that you can print fake vaccine cards off of Google Images. It was a big night right here in New York City as we elected our 110th mayor. I want to say congrats to Mayor-elect Eric Adams. Hey. Adams is a 61-year-old who doesn't eat meat, which means he can celebrate by eating as many New York City hot dogs as he wants. Switching gears here, thanks to ongoing supply chain issues, a massive drought, and lack of bottles, the country is now experiencing a wine shortage. Across America, moms and aunts are like, I feel a disturbance in the force. Actually, my aunt is on Facebook trying to get everyone to storm the Capitol. Wine shortage, it's serious. Right now, book club members are just sitting in a circle like, well, I guess we could talk about the book. Some more business news. I read that Nike is planning to enter the metaverse so it can start selling digital sneakers. That's right. They're expensive shoes that you can't actually wear, or as they're also known, heels. You're welcome. Hey, I want to say congrats to the Atlanta Braves, who just won the 2021 World Series. Yeah, it's the Braves' first World Series title since 1995, so it was a big night for their fans. Just check out this interview right here.
I live over 100 miles away, and I'm spend a night by myself. My family's at home. I'm gonna have to take off the next couple of days from work. I got a room. I'm gonna invite everybody over. They wanna come party with me, they come up party with me.
Well, I think we know what's causing that wine shortage. Well, get this. I saw that the rights to Alvin and the Chipmunks could be sold for over $300 million. This is huge. Now the Chipmunks might be able to afford the two things they've been missing, testosterone and pants. Well, this is interesting. A recent study identified deer as a widespread carrier of coronavirus. Right now, everyone's racking their brains like, did we eat inside with any deer last week? Lyme disease, COVID, getting close to a deer is basically like licking the floor at Port Authority. And finally, a new survey found that people who sleep naked are twice as likely to have a good night's sleep than people who wear pajamas. In response, the manager at Mattress Firm said, that's great, sir, but we're still gonna need you to leave. A week after renaming their company Meta, Facebook has learned that there's already another tech company called Meta, and they won't sell their name for less than $20 million. When asked why they didn't do their research, Facebook said, we did, we just did it on Facebook. Yeah, the name Meta is already being used. Facebook was like, fine, if that's taken, we're just gonna go with our backup choice, TikTok. Speaking of social media, this week, Jay-Z joined Instagram. Racked up more than 1 million followers, then deleted his account a day later. He was like, I don't want to get hooked. It'll be like Etsy all over again. Yeah, after 24 hours, Jay-Z said, sunsets, food, people's kids, I'm good. I don't need to do this. Yep, all it took was a day for Jay-Z to realize I'm a billionaire married to Beyonce. Who cares what anyone else is doing? Some news from Washington. The White House announced that their deadline for their workplace vaccine mandate is January 4th. It's great timing. Make sure everyone is vaccinated right after the holiday. Some more COVID news. I heard that there's a potentially faster spreading Delta variant moving through the U.S. called Delta Plus. It's basically the Delta variant, but if you get it, you can also stream movies and shows for $13. It's a good deal.
Extra leg room.
Some big sports news. Packers quarterback Aaron Rodgers has tested positive for COVID, and it turns out he may have lied about being vaccinated. Yeah, he told reporters he was immunized, which some people are saying is misleading. That's not the only confusing statement that he's made about his vaccine status. For example, in one press conference, he said, "I'd like to think of myself as vaccine adjacent." Wow. In another press conference, he said, "In a spiritual sense, are any of us truly vaccinated?" And finally, he cleared things up by saying, "I didn't not get the shot. Not." Some business news. I read that CVS wants to start hiring doctors so that they can become a major healthcare service provider. Yeah, instead of an x-ray, they'll just drag you across the scanner at the self-checkout machine. Sorry, it didn't go through. Get over here. That's right, CVS wants to hire doctors. Kind of interesting, but even more interesting are the questions on the application to become a CVS doctor. I'll show you what I mean. First up, there's, what medical school did you fail out of? Then there's, will you give extra care to anyone with an extra care card? Next up, there's, during the holidays, how many times can you hear I saw mommy kissing Santa Claus before going clinically insane? And finally, there's, are you comfortable using a CVS receipt as a tourniquet? Oh, that's, I never thought about that. Some more business news this weekend. UPS is looking to hire more than 60,000 employees at its annual Brown Friday event. And of course, they won't hire anyone because nobody will attend an event called Brown Friday. Here's how the UPS event works. It starts on Friday, but if you show up 3 days late, the job is yours. Hey, guys, today Starbucks debuted their festive new drink called the Iced Sugar Cookie Almond Milk Latte. But they're not the only ones getting into the holiday spirit. Check out this new ad I just saw from Dunkin' Donuts.
We here at Dunkin' are serving up some wicked awesome new holiday drinks. So come on down and get something for your kid brother. Like our new Christmas Clam Chowder Chino. Or how about a piping hot baked bean hot chocolate? Or maybe try our new Sam Adams Coolada. It's just a styrofoam cup filled with Sam Adams so you can drink it on the tea. Happy friggin' holidays from Dunkin'. We're thinking about getting Wi-Fi soon.
Hey, get this. I saw that a goat cheese from Spain just beat out over 4,000 other entries to win first place at the World Cheese Awards. Sounds delicious, but I wish they'd come up with a better name than a Goat Whiz.
Goat Whiz. That's not the real name. You're making that up.
What's that?
You're making that up.
No, no, I'm serious.
Really? It was Goat Whiz?
Yeah, I'm really
fantastic.
Serious. Finally, a couple in New Zealand unearthed a 17-pound potato that they think is the largest ever. Here's a photo of it. This is real.
Wow.
Look at the size of that. If you try to make mashed potatoes out of that thing, it actually fights back. Can we take a look at it again? Yeah. Looks like something you see on Brown Friday. Well, guys, this is very exciting. After being canceled last year due to the pandemic, the New York City Marathon is back this Sunday. It's gonna be a big day. It's gonna be a big day. At the starting line, runners will take off their masks and place them over their nipples. And my favorite part of the race is when runners cross the finish line, they immediately turn into Chipotle burritos. Of course, the race is 26.2 miles. And the only thing harder than running a marathon is listening to someone who just ran a marathon. Besides the marathon, this Sunday is also daylight savings time. It's the one thing Americans can all agree on, hating daylight savings time. No one quite likes it, yeah. It's that magical trade where we swap one extra hour of sleep for 5 months of seasonal depression. I think that's nice. Seriously, what's more fun than picking up your kids from school in total darkness? Papa, is that you? Come closer to my voice. Well, get this. I saw that New York City has extended its $100 vaccine incentive to kids ages 5 to 11. $100. Meanwhile, the smart kids are like, yeah, make it 200 or we start doing our own research. Kind of sets a bad precedent. I mean, every time you ask your kid to take medicine, they're going to be like, you forgetting something, pal? That's right. After getting the money, parents said, now don't waste it. The kid said, oh, like how you bought a $2,000 Peloton? Okay. I'm going to leave you in the darkness. Some more COVID news today. Apple began dropping mask mandates at some of its U.S. stores. Some think it's because of the declining cases, but others say it's just because Apple's about to release the iMask Pro. Of the $3,000. But Apple says safety is still their top priority. Then they went back to letting hundreds of strangers rub the same iPad.
Oh, this one looks nice. Lick it.
Meanwhile, I saw that Uber is bringing back Uberpool for the first time since the pandemic began. It's great news if you love the bus, but dream of something more intimate. Some entertainment news today. Marvel's Eternals finally hit theaters. Marvel fans haven't been this excited since 2 seconds ago when the last Marvel movie came out. Eternals is about a young poet trying to find her voice in post-war Europe. Just kidding. It's about laser-shooting mutants. Apparently, it's the first Marvel movie with a love scene. Oh. It's a little awkward. Basically, the guy thinks he's Iron Man, only to find out he's Ant-Man. You know what I'm saying?
Oh.
Hey, I heard about a Colorado man who set his mother's house on fire while trying to get rid of cobwebs with a blowtorch. When his mom said, did you get the cobwebs? He was like, technically, yes. And finally, a Southwest Airlines employee created a dress out of 800 lost luggage zipper pulls. When she asked her husband to zipper up, he finishes about 6 hours later. Hey, hey.